If you see this email from Siteground, don't ignore it, because some bad things will happen if you don't fix it right now. Hey guys, what's up? It's the WordPress Doctor here. And if you have a Siteground hosting account, you might encounter this email that your maximum allowed inode quota is almost being exceeded. Don't ignore this mail, because this is really important. Now, first of all, what is a inode? A inode is a file or an email stored within Siteground. Every hosting has these limits. So one file or one email is one inode. So you can imagine, if you have 3000 files for your website, you would have 3000 inodes in use with Siteground. You only have three options. Those are, first one, deleting files. Second is deleting emails. Or the third is upgrading to a new hosting plan. Well, I'm already at a GoGeek plan, so I don't want to buy another hosting plan. And I'm gonna show you that it's totally unnecessary to do so. Because I'm going to show you that these three options are not the only one you have. You actually have a fourth option, but it is a hidden or secret option. There are two ways to do this. I'm gonna show you the manual way. It's a lot of work. And after that, I'm going to show you a shortcut, because there is one, and that only will cost you 5 minutes. But of course, we're gonna try it for ourselves, just for the fun and to learn how these things actually work. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to log in with your Siteground account. Then you go to services, and then you see your hosting plans. As you can see, I now currently have two hosting plans. Those are two servers with the GoGeek account. Now my mail states that my first server is almost to exceed its inode's limits. So we're going to manage. And you go to statistics. If you go down to the inodes, you will see that from the 600,000 inodes I have, I only have 71,000 free. That is not very much. So something is happening on my server. Let's look at the first biggest user of your inodes. It's the biggest one. This has 27,850 inodes. All right, keep that in mind. Then you go to website and you open this link in a new tab. Go to the website which has the most inodes, and press on site tools right there. And then you press and hold shift key and you press all these three folders. And then we're gonna press this icon right here which says show folder size and inodes. Press it. And here you find a problem. Because as you can see, we now have 31 plus 17,923 plus 6. How much is that in total? It's roughly 18,000 inodes. Wait a second. What is going on? Because when I look at my inodes uses right here, it says almost 28,000. That is weird. Well, maybe she has 10,000 emails. Let's see. Email accounts. We're gonna log into the webmail. Although this person has a lot of mailboxes, I only can count the emails to 600 mails. So that counts for 600 inodes. That means that we are still 9,400 inodes short. Where are they? Let us look at another one. This one has 26,000. Select them all and I press this one. 26,000 versus... Wait a second, it is 16,000. Something is going on. As you can see, my websites generate 10,000 ghost inodes somewhere on the server. And those inodes are starting to add up if you have a lot of websites on your server. You might say, well, that 10,000 inodes, he must have 10,000 emails. And when I count all these individual emails, I only get to 1,000 emails max. So that means that we have 9,000 inodes that are ghosting, coming from somewhere I don't even know. So what's happening on your website is something called the opcache. And Siteground is caching your files, and it is just caching and caching and caching, and sometimes they don't empty that caching system. But I'm gonna show you how you can do that so you won't have to delete any files or delete any emails, because this thing works like a charm. What would be very useful is Siteground just has put a button down up here somewhere which says delete all the opcache files. And I always have a little bit of suspicion that hosting companies like you to buy another hosting plan. Unless they hate customers and unless they don't want to sell any more hosting plans. So the thing we're going to do right now is very technical. So you can follow along or just watch this, or you can skip to the shortcut that I will explain in roughly 10 minutes. So what are we going to do? I want to delete those 9,000 inodes that I'm missing from this website right here. I like to say it is pretty easy if you know how, but even if you know how, it is not pretty easy. So hang on, but it's gonna be fun. So let's go. The first thing we do, we need to download a program called Putty. Now this website looks like a website come from 1995 with a program also looks like it comes from 1984. However, the current release has been released just 1 month ago. So this program is actually really being maintained and it's free. Oh, if you want to download this yourself, I don't think you want, but if you do, link is in the description of this video. We're going to download the 64-bit version for Windows. Just press this button right there. It's gonna download and we're gonna install it right now. And when you fire Putty up, this is what you see. It is just this small thingy with a lot of things you need to do things with. To side tools, you go to the website you want to delete all those inodes from, and you go to the devs section right there. On the devs sections, you go to SSH Keys Manager right here. We are going to generate a key name. For example, WPressDoctor 2021. I'm gonna delete it afterwards, don't worry. And the password will be this, and we press generate. Now you need to press here and you have to press the private key. This is the private key. We need to copy it to clipboard right there. Open notepad. You paste in the key right there. You need to save this file somewhere on your computer called private-key.ppk. No, I'm not kidding, guys. This is how it actually works. All right, save this. After this, you need to run Putty Key Generator. You press this load button right there. And then you're gonna open the private-key.ppk file we have just saved. Then it's gonna ask you for the passphrase for this key. It's the password we've just generated. Press OK. And then it says it has successfully inserted. Okay, we press OK. Now you think, well, now we can start and do stuff. No, you cannot. First, you need to change the type of key to generate is gonna be DSA. Very important, don't skip this step, DSA right there. And then you need to press save private key and you're gonna save this key in another file with another name. Don't override your other key, no, save private key. Let's call it private key dev and press save. We can close this key generator right there and we're gonna open a new Putty. It's called pagent.exe. And when you start it, it most likely says that it's already running. So in your task manager, if you open it up, you can see a very little icon which says pagent. Right click on that one and you press add key. Then you select the file we've just generated the second time. Add key. Private key dev and you press open. And now you need to add again the password. So we're gonna add our password in, press okay. And now we can start up Putty itself, Putty configuration. All right, so because we have now generated all the keys and it is now connected to our server, to this specific website, and now we're gonna fill out this one. The first thing we need is our host name or IP address from our website. Is just your website URL, then you need to change the port to 18765 and then you can press open. Then you press yes and then you see this. This looks like some kind of hacker screen or anything, but now we are connected to our server. All right, then we type in our username and you have to be fast or else it will close your connection. All right, then we are locked in, and then now we can send some commands to our server. Be very careful, because you can also delete your entire website right now if you fill in the wrong stuff. But now we're gonna enter in the secret command, and it is this. Press the right mouse button if you don't see it right now, and then you press enter. And that's it. Now it has done something on your website. Well, let's check our inodes if something has changed on this specific website. That wasn't so hard, was it? And once you have refreshed this page, now you can see that the website is actually gone from this list and I have more free inodes. What has happened? Well, let's look at our website where it went right there. And it's all the way down to 19,213 inodes. That is actually a difference of 8,000 inodes. So we've cleared up 8,000 inodes doing it this way. However, if you see my entire list of websites, it's gonna be a lot of work to connect all with these websites one by one using Putty, generate keys, save them, upload them, connect again, running the things, and whoa. So there's a shortcut, and I'm gonna show you right now. You just go through this button right here, the big question mark, and then you press on View Help Center. Then you press on the right button down up there, slash says contact us. And then you go down and you go to WordPress and you press WordPress Assistance. And then you select the website that you want to remove all your inodes from. And then you're gonna type in this question. Hey there, awesome guys. I have a question. Can you delete for me the opcache files? Because my inodes are getting out of control. Thank you very much in advance. Greetings. And then you press this submit button. Then you go to chat. And then someone is almost instantly going to help us out with our question to delete the opcache files. Now, let's see what they say. So he's going to create a ticket for someone else to do it, because I think it's a little bit of technical, and maybe they also need to log in with this Putty. I don't know, but they're going to do it for us. So this is the best shortcut ever, because it's going to save me a lot of time with all these different websites. You know what I find out with life? If you are being positive and helpful and happy, all these guys will also be very happy and positive and will help you out, because they really want to, because you're so nice and positive person. So always keep in mind, when talking to customer service, be the nicest guy or girl you can ever be. So the Siteground employee did what he promised. He created a ticket for me, and some other guy just picked it up immediately, and within 5 minutes, I got this email, which says our ticket has been updated. So let's see what its ticket is all about. So it basically says, thank you for contacting us. We have done as you ask, and we have deleted the Zend OP cache on your server. So let's find out how much inodes we just made clear. Would you look at that? We have now 150,000 inodes free. That is a lot of free space right there. So now you know, if you run into this problem, you can do it yourself using this Putty method, or you can just ask Siteground and they will do it for you within a couple of minutes. I hope this video helped you out. Give it a thumbs up if it did. And if you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Subscribe, of course, if you want to see more helpful videos like this about WordPress, Divi, and everything WordPress related. And I see you guys in the next video.